Anyway, luckily that same way came because the French wanted a partner to develop their so-called Vikas engine. They had an M40 engine, which, as I told in the beginning, was a derivative of, I'm sorry, some of the names may not strike very, familiarity with you, but you have to put up with me. The smuggled prisoners of war, with their help, German prisoners of war, with their help, they made the so-called Veronique, and then Wallowa, and then Corrali, and then those kind of engines. They had an engine called M40. The M40 is the grandfather of the Vikas engine. So they said, we want to develop it, we want a joint partner. Anyway, we made an equation. Equation is a very simple equation saying that, what is the price of it? X rupees. Okay, this price will not be paid by us as money, but as a kind. What is a kind? We will work for you. We will come and work for you. After all, it is a joint development. So we have to give you manpower, we will come in. At that time, I used your name very liberally, saying that there are a lot of IITians who are better than any of your students here from Ecole Militaire and things like that. So in all senses, I could make use of all the IIT's name, though our strength at that time was 10, out of 53 people, only 10 or 12 IITians were there. But we went there. So with no cash transfer basis, the starting point of session on the contract is that this contract is on the principle of no cash transfer. So we went there, we worked there, and we jointly developed it. And of course, I named the engine as, in India, it is known as Vikas. And many people thought that it is meaning development, but it is a tribute of Vikram A. Sarabhai. This is the name I gave it. So today it is known in India as Vikas engine, though it is a joint development of the Viking engine. So it was actually Sessions' brainchild, if you put it that way. But many people do not know contribution of an IAS officer in the development of ISRO's Vikas engine. I don't think that any one of you know it, actually. So this is part of history, so that's why I just thought I'll make it known to you that how people from different walks of life have contributed to this. So during Professor Dhawan's period, we made this Vikas engine. And when we came back to India, the usual talk is that these people have gone there and then roamed around the Lido clubs and crazy halls and stuff like that, and they have no idea about what is Viking or Vikas. So in order to shut their mouth, we made a model using model materials, and we exhibited there. This is what is the so-called Vikas engine. Ah, it's only a model. Now let us make the real thing, then only the color will be out. So what I said, I didn't know what to do, because as Dhawan wanted, without money, we made the whole thing. But then we are not able to proceed further. So I added one thing there. My name is Vikas engine. My thrust is 60 ton. My burning duration is 140 seconds, etc., etc. At the end of it, I added saying that I am an orphan. And the professor Dhawan, while passing through the foyer, he just stopped it there and then he asked, "What do you mean by orphan?" I said, "Orphan is orphan, you know." Then he asked, "How much money you want for making a working engine?" I said, "A real working engine would cost you about a crore." "Okay, you bring the papers." He gave 1 crore. The problem was the quantity of material you have to order has to have a minimum quantity. For example, if you want to buy O-rings, you can't buy 10 O-rings. But all kinds of things followed, not to be recorded. We smuggled O-rings and we seals, and then we brought the help of some people, a passenger who will bring this, bring that. And finally, we made a working Vikas engine. Then, oh, this is a working engine, that's what the Nambi fellow claims. But how do we know it works? Now, we need a test stand to make it work, and we don't have a test stand. And we want a test stand, it would cost you 100 crores. And there is no specific place, neither place nor stand, nothing. And by the time, I was telling to Professor Dhawan, "Sir, it will work." Then he said, can you prove this? I said, yes. Give me another crore, I will prove it. I said, but people say 100 crores. No, no, no. To prove that it will work, I need only 1 crore. He asked, tell me, man, how? I said, I'll test it in the same engine, same test bed in France. Will they accept your engine? I said, it is my job. Leave it to me. So I went and told my colleagues there, thanks to them. They said, we will inspect all the documents, whether you have done it exactly as per procedure. I said, come along. So they came and then inspected it and all. Finally, they said, okay, we will test it. The 1 crore we paid, 60 lakhs goes for the propellant alone, which will be consumed. So only the 40 lakhs is the real fees we pay. That too goes for 30 lakhs goes for the insurance, because if we blast the test bed, then they have to get their money back. So we tested it. Though the requirement was 140 seconds, I was at the height of vexation. I said, how much maximum you can go the burning duration? They said, the capacity of the tank, you can go up to 180 seconds. I said, go. So we went up to 180 seconds. It was working beautifully. It took the CD of it. Next flight came back to India. And it was my job to call the big stalwarts and then say, there is a movie being screened showing the firing, hot firing of the Vikas engine. You may like to see. But anyway, this is how the so-called Vikas engine got into the PSLV program. I am trying to illustrate this as brief as possible, but the story is pretty long because it's a period of more than 19 years. So we got into the successful PSLVs, 40 numbers with not even one failure, GSLVs, not failures, Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan, all are carried by this Vikas. But please understand the agony one has gone through that. From outside, when you look at it, ISRO, oh, great, success. But I don't think that you know what has really meted out by people. So, in fact, in this venture, I have many IITians there, and many of you may like to come to ISRO. But let me tell you that, and it was not to discourage you, I told the entire story. It still, we could succeed in the entire thing, but unfortunately, Sarabhai was not alive. And Professor Dhawan was alive, yes, of course. Then we have, afterwards there was no going back on it. Then to make us a full space power, what you needed was the cryogenic technology. Then my Princetonian colleague came in my mind. So it's a long story. On another occasion, if you care to invite me, I will come and tell you the cryogenic manipulations and management and then delivery of that. But still, I will just briefly say that we signed a contract, and that contract couldn't go through fully. It ended up into a fiasco, what is called the ISRO spy case. But the cryogenic certainly came through, though it was a delayed product. With that today, what we have, different modules of solid, liquid, and cryogenic. You have as small a rocket of 75 millimeter diameter, 3-inch diameter, to 3 meters diameters. The solid propellant rocket, the booster is 3 meter, 2.9 meter if I am exact. Then you have liquid rockets varying between 600 kg or even 50 kg, 600 kg, then 3 ton, and then 60 ton. Now you have 110 ton. And then you have the cryogenic engine of different capacities.